Hello everyone, my name is Anirudh Mittal. I'm currently a fourth year undergraduate. I am pursuing an interdisciplinary dual degree with my master's in artificial intelligence and data science, which is the C-Minds department, and my bachelor's is in chemical engineering. Right, okay. So I did not do any honors in the chemical department in C-Minds. Currently, from what I know, they don't offer an honors degree. So I think when I discuss the curriculum, you will figure out that there are only four courses as part of the PG elective along with the DDP. And I think the trend is whenever there are four courses as part of PG electives, it's without honors. And whenever you see eight courses, it's usually with honors. In C-Minds, they don't have an option currently for with honors. So I started considering sometime in June 2020, right after my sixth semester. So I started with considering a dual degree in chemical engineering. Then simultaneously, so my plan was to pursue computer science after graduation. So even if I had done that, I would have tried to make it everything, make my project related to computer science and more specifically maybe related to artificial intelligence. So that time, a couple of people recommended that I look into IEEE DP. So that time I was looking into IEEE DP IUR and electrical department. That time C-Minds wasn't there. I think they were figuring out the policy and everything. So my three options at that point of time were dual degree in chemical engineering, IEEE DP in IUR, and IEEE DP in electrical department. And actually IUR is something that I will recommend to a lot of people who are thinking about doing in C-Minds. Because it's, I think not a lot of people know about it, but they also have a lot of interesting projects. A lot of people, professors are working in artificial intelligence and many other interesting areas related to probability and mathematics that I feel many people are interested in, but they are not aware of. So I think at the end of June, I dropped an email to the HOD of CSE department, just checking if they have introduced a new. They don't have an IEEE DP, but I still wanted to check. That time they told me that they're going to come up with C-Minds. Then I got in touch with the HOD, Professor Sumita Saraogi, and then she, you know, gave me a brief idea that something like this is going to come up. So yes, I mean, that was the timeline of consideration. Okay, so I don't think so I have a very clear answer for this. I was, when I used to be a BTEC back in June 2020, I was planning to apply for a master's in computer science. The option for, so I think it was more like an option for directly applying after graduation or maybe staying for one more year. So there were a lot of factors behind converting to a dual degree or IEEE DP. And I think a small fraction of it would be related to pandemic also, which might not be relevant for the future applicants. But for me, it was the pandemic, the online semester, everything came into the picture. And I felt like this is a good opportunity to stay back in the institute for one more year, focus completely on research on related to computer science. Because before that, all my experience was through the computer science minor, through a couple of internships, and one project that I had done. One research that I had started. So I felt like it would be better if I have some dedicated time to this. It will improve my application whenever I apply. For example, if I apply this year, I will have a much better application as compared to the last year. So as I mentioned, I discussed with Professor Sunita Saraogi about what's going to happen, what's the eligibility criteria and everything. So she told me that they are going to have four courses as part of the PG electives. They don't have an option of eight electives. Some departments offer, I think, both. And these four courses are supposed to be from like a huge list of courses that they have provided across departments from computer science, electrical, IUR, maths, CNR, even chemical department. And they have divided all the courses into three buckets: mathematics, applications, and AI. So you can just take any four courses from this as part of the PG electives. So yes, I found out about this through the HOD. Yes, Yeah, so I think in our case, the process was very different. Before that, it used to be manual and there was no fixed deadline. In our case, we got an email saying that the deadline is the next day. It later got extended to one more day. So basically, we had a time, the entire application timeline comprised within 2 days. So the process was, there was a form in the AMS portal in which we were supposed to fill out our statement of purpose, course plan, previous research experience, other basic details, professor potential guides, the department we want to IEEE into, and things like that. Basically, we had to fill out the form in 2 days. And after which, we are supposed to get certain signatures for the application. The first of which is from the convener of the parent DUGC, which in my case is Chemicals. So after completing my application, I sent the application to HOD Chemical. After getting his approval on my application, basically on the AMS portal, they have to just make a signature, digital signature. After that, I got approval from the DUGC convener of the host department, which in my case is Professor Sunanda Saraogi, HOD of C-Mines. After getting her approval, I sent the form to the CAD section. In the middle, I also sent my application to the professors I have worked with. Basically, there's a research section and you mentioned the projects you have worked on. You mentioned the professors you have worked with. So you have to, I thought it would be good if I have their confirmation next to the project. It might make my application better. Also, the potential guide for the IEEE, I had listed down a couple of names. I could talk to only one professor in the time, and I had got a verbal confirmation. So if you have more time, I couldn't get my guide's signature on my application. But I think if any applicant can do that, I think it will make their application more stronger. So yes, I think that was the timeline. So getting signatures took about 10 to 15 days from all these three bodies. Mean time took between the get submitting it to the CAD section to the final result, which is about like 25 to 30 days. Right. So I think for C-Mines, the good thing is that it's interdisciplinary, which is you can find a guide in like any department, starting from computer science, electrical, to even SOM. I know a couple of people who are working with SOM professors, at least planning to work with SOM professors, and even your parent department, you can find a guide. You can find a co-guide from multiple departments. So I think that's the cool thing about it. And I think in my case, I wanted to work in NLP specifically. So I worked with the professor who works in NLP. So in my case, it was pretty straightforward, but I think you can even take your time. I mean, for the application, you have to just submit a list of potential people. It's not binding in the sense that if you write a name, you will have to work with that person. You kind of have like another 8 to 10 months to figure out who you want to work with. I think March or April 2020, the next year is going to be the deadline for that. So yes, I mean, you even have an option to explore in the next 2 semesters by taking different courses from the list of courses that I mentioned. And based on that, maybe you can pick out the guide. In my case, I took one course in NLP in the 7th semester. I liked that course. The course project that I worked on was very interesting. So I continued working on that course project, and more or less that's going to become my DDP project. Right. So for I think the first eligibility criteria is that there's a CPI constraint of 7.5. Your CPI should be above 7.5. Other than that, I don't think so. There was any other criteria. I think going forward, they are planning to introduce a criteria for C-Mine specifically that you should have completed 2 minor courses or 2 elective courses. I'm not very sure. So I think you should discuss with the admission, whoever is the professor in charge for the admissions. But yeah, CPI is, I think CPI and there should not be any FRs, or I think there's some category limit that it should be category 1 or 2. All that you can, I think, check with the academic section or the admissions committee. So this is the eligibility criteria. Other than that, the selection for the selection, I think they look at your application. The DUGC of your parent department should first approve it, which I think should be fairly simple if you have completed all your courses and if you don't have any backlogs. The DUGC host checks the entire application, I believe. They check your statement of purpose, your research experience, and based on that, they filter out of all the applications. So let's say there are 50 applications, so I'm guessing they'll filter like 20, just select like 20 applications based on the level of experience and how well your statement of purpose is, so all those things. And you also have to mention your course plan. So basically course plan is just to make sure that it's possible for you to complete your IEEE. It won't be very hectic, like you won't have to take like 60 credits, or I'm not sure what's the exact threshold, but you won't have to take a lot of courses just to complete your degree. So after filtering that, they send it to the academic section, after which it's just like CPI filtering, which is, let's say if there are 8 seats in our year, there were 8 seats for the TA ship category. So out of all the applications that were forwarded by the DOGC of the host department, which is CMINES, they just selected the top 8 based on CPI. So yeah, that's the criteria. That's the entire selection procedure. Right. So for that, the criteria is basically you have to complete 4 PG courses, PG electives, and then your dual degree project. As I mentioned, we have 4 because we don't have the provision for honors. Some other departments have 8 courses because they have honors. So for us, it's just 4 PG electives from the big list of courses that they give, plus the DDP. Right. So I think if you're applying this year, you probably don't have a lot of time to focus on other aspects other than just the SOP. But SOP also is something I think you guys should focus very, very properly on, just something like people do on in their NS applications or PhD applications, maybe get it reviewed by a couple of seniors, because that can actually bring out and make a case for you that why you want to convert. To be honest, I don't know what exactly the committee looks at while they're reviewing your applications. But it's good if you can, you know, improve on every possible aspect, which also, so let's say if you are a second year student or a first year student who's planning well in advance, then in that case, maybe you should work on the other aspects also, which is they ask for your research experience. If you have worked with any professor or any internships that you have done, any all the courses that you have taken related to artificial intelligence or data science. So all these aspects, maybe you can work on in advance. And other than that, as I mentioned, it's good if you have confirmation from a potential guide. I think it again makes your application stronger. That's it. Not really. So in our case, I think there was a lot of uncertainty because CMINES was it was the first year for the department. So I think a couple of things weren't very clear, and we got to know about those things while we were in the process. But I think it should not be a problem for the future batches. The other problem was about our process started very late. It happened, I think, sometime in June 2020, and the results came out in middle of August, which was a problem for some of us because we were BTEC students and we were supposed to, you know, sit for placements or prepare for masters. So that led to some uncertainty, but I think more or less it was fine because everything happened online. The AMS portal works properly. So yeah, in general, the process was pretty smooth. So after you convert to IEEE, no, I don't think so. I mean, basically you have to just take your time to figure out who your guide is going to be. So just after you convert, you have until your 8th semester, I guess, after the end of the 8th semester, to decide who your guide is going to be and even choose your project, the DDP project. Maybe some people can even start working just after the 7th semester. I think that's more or less it. You can just plan your 4 courses. Since it's 4 courses, I don't think that's going to be a big problem. Even you can complete in the 5th year. But in my case, I completed 1 course in the 7th semester, 1 more in the 8th semester. So now I have like 2 courses for the final year. So that's more or less it. From the administration side, we haven't discussed anything from the administration, or we haven't been asked to do anything else. So nothing major. So in my case, I just applied for CMINES, which is you have to fill your preference for your host department. So I had filled CMINES, but I guess you can fill multiple options also. So for people, since Siemens has become very competitive now, a lot of people know about it, and you can even prepare in advance. You have a lot of time for your application. In case you don't get into Siemens, maybe you can consider other departments. For example, as I mentioned, I was considering IOR and electrical, and even your core department, I mean your parent department, you can consider a dual degree in that. And your project, you can make it in a way that you get to learn what you really wanted to learn through your IEEE DP. For example, I talked to someone who was in metallurgy, and they wanted to go in a particular department, but because of some eligibility criteria, they weren't able to. So I recommended that their dual degree project, they can make it in a way that they're working with a metallurgy professor, and they can make a co-guide from the other department and try to work on a interdisciplinary project. You won't definitely get the degree in that way, but still you will have like a 1 year long project in your area of choice. So yes, I mean, since IEEE DP is becoming very competitive, this is one other option you can consider. And in fact, there are other departments that you should probably explore. There are many good departments that we don't even explore. So I think that is one thing. Maybe you should reach out to people who have converted. If no one has converted, then maybe you should reach out to the student representatives from their department or directly the professors or the HOD to figure out how many courses, what is their requirement for IEEE DP, and discuss with professors what are the potential projects you can work on.